TNUEF, which is a very important organization. It's a broad platform of many organizations that are fighting for the dignity and rights of Dalits and against many forms of untouchability that still exist in Tamil Nadu. And actually, this organization has now brought together all the different movements fighting on these issues in Tamil Nadu. And many people of the left are also in these organizations. And even SFI, DYFI, ADWA, they are also part of this broad platform. So it's a very important initiative. The problem is that even after so many years of struggle, the atrocities and the discrimination is continuing as before, maybe even worse. For example, in the last 1 month, there have been 4 incidents of honor killing in Tamil Nadu. 4 of honor killing and 1 of atrocity. 2 instances, the husband and wife have both been killed. And it's very tragic that in 1 or 2 of these instances, the marriage is between inter-subcastes. It's not inter-caste, but inter-subcaste. Even their identity politics has become so important that even there, they are willing to kill their children. So it's a horrible thing. In Kumbakonam, there has been an instance of a man whose body, dead body, was being taken even after it had been decided that it would be allowed through the upper caste area. And the people taking the body were attacked and many of them are wounded. Apart from that, there are many instances, many children in many schools, they are wearing caste identity bands. And in fact, the department had given a circular that these should be stopped. But BJP opposed this, saying that this is anti-Hindu, stopping that band being worn. And so the government is totally under the influence of the BJP. So the minister has also issued a circular saying to ignore the earlier circular and these bans will be allowed. Now what is happening is that the children are complaining that on the basis of the caste they are being victimized. They are not allowed to participate in sports. They are not allowed to sit with the other children and they are being discriminated against in many ways. So, I mean, after 73 years of independence that we are celebrating last year, this is the actual position that small things and big things are all witnessing terrible discrimination against Dalits and lower caste people. So what we have to really understand is that, especially after this government has come, BJP at the center and in many states, there's a change situation because BJP is the only political group that actually does not accept Ambedkar's constitution and has never accepted. They have always been in favor of Manusmriti. So they promote inequality even more openly than other political parties and other groups. And that is why we are seeing that in every sphere, actually it is the principles of Manusmriti that are being implemented. For example, Manusmriti says that for the same crime, different punishment will be given depending on your caste. So if a upper caste person kills a lower caste person, the punishment will be very mild. And he will just have to give some feast for some Brahmins or something like that, called prayashchitam. But if a lower caste person kills an upper caste person, then the punishment is death. So the rule of law will not apply anymore. And already we are seeing that this is happening. Those who killed Pehlu Khan, the people are saying there is no proof, even though he gave a dying declaration, even though witnesses were there. But all those people have gone scot-free. But people accused of terrorism, Hindus accused of terrorism, accused of rioting, and all these kind of very heinous crimes, all the cases against them are being withdrawn. So this is Manusmriti. This is the implementation of Manusmriti. Different punishment according to your birth for the same crime. Similarly, we are seeing that education is becoming more and more difficult for poor people. And poor people means Dalits, Adivasis, OBCs, landless people, women. And now with the emphasis on private education, which has been there, which is there now in the draft education program, new education program. So that means even more exclusion of the poorest people, which of course the largest number is always Dalit and Adivasi. So their education will be denied to them. So education and proper professions, if they are excluded from both these areas, then that is also Manusmriti, because Manusmriti says that Dalits and Shudras should not be educated, they should only get menial work, they should only be slaves to the upper caste. So in different ways this is being implemented. Then last year we had seen how the Supreme Court gave a verdict that the SCST Act should be weakened considerably. And both those judges, we know what is their history, so I don't need to go into that. And the thing was that there was an agitation against it like we have not seen in India. That also we should remember. In North India, on the Bandh Day, thousands and thousands and thousands of young Dalits, middle-aged Dalits, they came on the streets and they enforced the Bandh. And many people supported them also. But the governments in Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan and UP, all three were BJP at the time, they came down against the Dalits as if they were their enemies. They were beaten, they were arrested, Dr. Ambedkar's statue was broken, thousands of them were put in jail. Minor boys were kept with the hardened criminals and they were refused bail for months and months and months. And actually it was only the left parties and DSMM that intervened and dared to speak against it. We were able to get bail, we got many of them released also. But still, even though the government has changed in Rajasthan and in MP, the justice has not yet been done. This shows how much that thinking of Manusmriti has entered our general way of thinking and is influencing the way governments are behaving. So it's a very tough battle, but we should also remember that we cannot fight this battle on the basis of caste. It's not a caste battle. It's a battle for democracy and for equal rights, and all those who are interested in democracy and equal rights, whether it's women, employees, workers, peasants, SCs, STs, Dalits, minorities, they must all come together to defend the constitution, to defend equal rights. And they must also see what is happening in Kashmir as a big attack on democracy. That 15th of August, which is being celebrated as our day of freedom, in Kashmir, the people are not free, let alone celebrate, they're not allowed to come out on the road. So we should understand that if in one part of the country, our own fellow citizens can be kept in this state, nobody can save us if we don't fight. We can also be submitted to the same attack. And obviously, democracy is most needed by those who are the most oppressed. So all those who are fighting for Dalit rights must now fight also to defend the constitution and to defend democracy.